Whenever I looked up from my writing, I saw M. Hamel sitting motionless in his chair and gazing first at one thing, then at another, as if he wanted to fix in his mind just how everything looked in that little schoolroom. Fancy, for 40 years he had been there in the same place with his garden outside the window and his class in front of him. Just like that. Only the desks and benches had been overly smooth, the walnut trees in the garden were taller, and the hop vine that he had planted himself twined about the windows to the roof. How it must have broken his heart to leave it all. Poor man, to hear his sister moving about in the room above, packing their trunks, for they must leave the country next day. As the students were doing the work of writing, and whenever Frank looked up from his writing, he saw that his teacher, Mr. M. Hamel, was sitting motionless in his chair. He was staring first at one thing, then at another thing that were in the classroom. Actually, the teacher was staring at each and everything that was in the classroom, as if he wanted to fix each and everything in his mind forever. As he wanted to remember each and everything in the classroom, how they looked in the schoolroom, just imagine. Mr. M. Hamel had been teaching in that school for 40 years. And whenever he sat in his classroom, his students were in front of him, and his garden was outside the window. And he could see his garden through the window of the classroom. M. Hamel was extremely sad for leaving these things. There was no change in the school room. Only the desk and benches had been worn smooth because of being used. He had planted some walnut trees in his garden, and they had become taller. And he had planted a hop vine himself, which had twined about the windows and reached the roof. All these things must have broken his heart to leave. And he was extremely sad when he heard his sister, who was moving about in the room above the classroom. She was packing the things into the big boxes, because the teacher and his sister were to leave the country the next day. But he had the courage to hear every lesson to the very last. After the writing, we had a lesson in history, and then the babies chanted their ba baby bo bo down there at the back of the room. Old Hauser had put on his spectacles and, holding his primer in both hands, he sped the letters with them. You could see that he too was crying. His voice trembled with emotion, and it was so funny to hear him that we all wanted to laugh and cry. Ah, how well I remember it, that last lesson. On the day of the last lesson, the teacher displayed extraordinary courage to hear every lesson to the students to the very last time. When the work of writing was completed, the students had a lesson in history, and the small children read their ba, be, bi, bo, bu. And as the manager was sitting on the back benches of the class, and Mr. Goldhauser had put on his spectacles. He had his primer in his hand, and he was also trying to read the letters with the children. He was very sad. He was crying. He was so sad that his voice was trembling with emotions. On one side, it appeared the students to be funny, to be very strange, and on the other side, they wanted to laugh and cry. As the narrator paid much attention to the last lesson, so he could never forget it even today. He said that he remembers the last lesson very well. If the students listen to their teachers attentively, they can understand each and everything taught by their teachers, and they will never forget it. They will remember it forever. As the narrator heard the last lesson so attentively, so carefully, that he found it very, very easy to understand, and he could never forget it. He remembered it once for all. All at once, the church clock struck 12. Then the angelus, at the same moment, the trumpets of the Prussians returning from drill sounded under our windows. M. Hamel stood up very pale in his chair. I never saw him look so dull. "My friend, sir," said he, but something choked him. He could not go on. Then he turned to the blackboard, took a piece of chalk, and bearing on with all his might, he wrote as large as he could, "Vive la France." Then he stopped and leaned his head against the wall, and without a word, he made a gesture to us with his hand. "The school is dismissed. You may go."